please.
Congressman Weber, Senator Horkan, and dear friends of the Iranian resistance, Mr. Higgins, welcome to the home of the Iranian resistance. It's a pleasure to have you with us here today. Our movement takes immense pride in the enduring friendship we share with individuals like yourselves, who have always stood with the Iranian people in their pursuit of justice and their tireless struggle against the oppressive religious dictatorship ruling Iran. Your support during these challenging times is deeply appreciated by the Iranian people. The Iranian resistance and the MEK have the experience of over half a century of fighting for freedom against two dictatorships of the Shah and the clerical regime. The good news is that the prospect for overthrowing the regime and establishing a free and democratic republic in Iran shines brighter today than ever before. We are getting close to September 16, and that was the beginning day of the nationwide uprising in Iran. The world witnessed the demand of the Iranian people, an end to this brutal regime and the establishment of a free and democratic republic where the power ultimately resides with the people of Iran. Despite a massive and brutal crackdown by the regime to silence any dissent, the Iranian people's determination for regime change remains unbroken. The regime arrested over 30,000 individuals and tragically murdered more than 750 protesters, mainly young men and women in the streets. In recent weeks, the regime has intensified its suppression, including a new wave of mass arrests. Just last week, Javad Rouhi, a protester who had been under severe torture in prison over the past several months, lost his life in suspicious circumstances. Here is the picture of Javad Rouhi. The killing of the protesters under torture while in prison or after they have been released is routine. But the regime resorts to these killings in fear of more uprisings and the prospects of its downfall. Despite brutal suppression, the regime cannot eliminate the causes of the uprising because the roots of what sparked the nationwide uprising persist. Economic and social crisis, along with crippling poverty, continue to worsen. The regime has no solution for an explosive society that seeks freedom. In the face of the culture of resistance and perseverance of the Iranian people and resistance, the regime tries to delay its downfall by intensifying suppression. The resistance network inside Iran continues to expand with an increasing number of young women and men joining the ranks of the MEK network and resistance units. For years, the regime deliberately avoided mentioning the MEK and NCRI, attempting to to make believe. It's big lie that there is no viable alternative and that the democratic opposition had no support within the country. But the presence and activities of the resistance units and the resistance's network have reached such a level that the regime was forced to change its position on this matter. Today, regime officials openly acknowledge their concern about the decisive role of the MEK resistance units in the uprising and about the growing number of youth supporting our goals. On July 12, 2023, Qalibov, the current speaker of the regime's parliament, summing up the uprising, said, MEK had the biggest role in organizing and carrying out these protests. In recent weeks, the state-controlled media have published many articles, TV and radio reports, as well as statements by regime officials, all aimed at countering the growing support for the MEK within Iran. Furthermore, the regime is increasingly alarmed by the international recognition of the NCRI as a democratic and viable alternative to the current regime by Western parliaments. Therefore, the regime has intensified its demonization campaign against the NCRI and MEK, also resorting to terrorism, hostage taking, and other intimidating means to compel other countries to restrict the legitimate activities of the Iranian opposition. The regime's focus on MEK members in Ashraf Tiri demonstrates its fear of their impactful role. But let it be clear, nothing can prevent the MEK and the residents of Ashraf from pursuing their goal to free Iran. For years, the policy of appeasement has contributed to the regime's survival. A new policy is long overdue. The Iranian people's quest for freedom and democracy will continue until the overthrow of this brutal regime. The regime's atrocities will not deter our people in their quest for freedom, but will only make them and the resistance even more determined to pay the price for a free and democratic Iran. I thank you again for your invaluable support in these trying times. Thank you very much.